How Adopt a Buddy Works by Timothy Rohr. Adopt a Buddy is a virtual volunteer program in which someone with a disability, such as autism, Down syndrome, cerebral palsy, etc., are paired up with a non-disabled peer for the person with a disability to virtually communicate with them and maintain meaningful friendships together. Although the program is virtual, if you feel comfortable with your buddy after some time and want to meet in person, I will include some tips and advice on how to best to interact with them. The goal of Adopt a Buddy is to help people with disabilities not feel socially isolated by the non-disabled population. To be a buddy for someone with a disability, here are things to remember if you want to volunteer for Adopt a Buddy. Number 1. A disability does not determine a person's true character. People with disabilities are not any less of a person than you are. They are capable, smart, social, and outgoing as much as you are. They may look different or take longer to do things. They just need help by non-disabled people to do things more conveniently. Never judge people with disabilities by their challenges. Honor the things that they are already capable of doing. Number 2, getting to know them. When you get to know people with disabilities, it's not any different from getting to know someone without a disability. You get to know someone with a disability the same way as your other friends, but with providing people with disabilities accommodations, such as being patient with them and giving them social breaks when they want privacy. When you and them get to know each other, ask them things you want to know about them. Learn about their hobbies, their favorite games, their favorite things to watch, if they have any pets or siblings, and even about interests that are unique to them. If people with disabilities, particularly autism, talk about things such as superheroes, exit signs, what time people eat their meals, or other topics that are discussed in a way that may not seem typical to you, talk about those interests with them. Some of their interests may be one-sided. To manage talking to them about their one-sided interests, give them up to 15 minutes for them to discuss their interests, and when the time comes, offer to talk about your interests. Always take turns about what you want to talk about and what your buddy with a disability wants to talk about. Number 3, remember to keep in contact with them. People with disabilities have electronic devices to reach out to people as well. They also may have social media. Be sure to keep their phone numbers in your contacts, save their email addresses, and never unfollow or block them on social media. When your buddy with a disability sends you text messages to greet you or talk about their interests, be sure to respond to them every few times a week. Make the first approach and be sure to send them a text or give them a call. If you don't hear back from them in hours, be patient for them to respond or call back. If you don't hear back from them longer than 1 to 3 days, try reaching out to them again or say something like, "Hi, did you get my message?" Number 4, use your able bodies to help them. Not having a disability is something to be thankful for. While you are thankful to not have a disability, use your able bodies to help people with disabilities. Open the door, carry items for them, go upstairs or downstairs, help them with their work and hobbies, and for them to be your best friend. While you are thankful to not have a disability, your buddy with a disability will be thankful to have an able-bodied friend like you in their life. Number 5, make memories with them. You love going to beaches, parks, restaurants, movie theaters, malls, and other places such as sporting events and concerts. People with disabilities like going to those places too, while you and your buddy with a disability talk to each other through your electronic devices, or when you see them at school, work, church, or at any event. Be sure to make plans to hang out with them. Your buddy with a disability will be happy to soak up the sun at the beach with you, have a nice picnic at the park, grab something delicious to eat at a restaurant, see a spectacular movie, shop at the mall, or have the time of their life at a sporting event or a concert. Please note that people with disabilities, especially autism, may be sensitive to loud noises, bright lights, strong smells, or even heights. If sporting events and concerts bother them, make plans to hang out at an amusement park instead. If amusement park rides bother them, go to the beach instead. If the beach bothers them, then go to the park or the mall instead. But wherever you plan to hang out with your buddy with a disability, make sure you and them both agree to the place you and them are getting together at. While you and your buddy with a disability are making memories together by hanging out, be sure to capture photos of you and them together. You and your buddy with a disability will be thankful to keep those memorable photos. Number 6, drive them. Driving a car is a privilege that most of us have. On the other hand, people with disabilities may not have that privilege because of their limitations. They still need transportation to get places. For many people who have disabilities, being a passenger is the safest option for them. But their parents or their other family members do not always have the time to drive people with disabilities to places. If you have a car, be sure to give them rides to where you and them are going to hang out at, and to places where they need to go to, such as a grocery store or to their jobs. Thank you for learning about how Adopt a Buddy works. We hope that you can join Adopt a Buddy. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Tips for Inclusion, the number 4. Check out my other videos and share my videos with your friends, family, and everyone around you. Check out my website and social media.